Hello guys again. Star Ocean First Depeche, right? My favorite on just, and I think the bestest game on just from this series, which is Star Ocean, actually, right? And it's kind of funny, what? Well, I mean, yeah, it's kind of extremely just hard to just choose between the just Star Ocean Second Evolution Until the End of Time, right? I suppose. But for me personally, right, the most romantic, the most simple, and at the same time, it's this home feeling, you know, just when you just totally feel yourself like just in comfort with story, characters, and just with the series itself, actually, right? Just the representative of the series, right? Like Final Fantasy IV is just for me being a Final Fantasy. Same goes with Star Ocean's third Depeche, which is just supposed to be representative of Star Ocean game, right? A lot of people think what it's like. People from who just make the Tales of games, right? We just take the best ideas from the Tales of just Fantasia, right? And just create their own series, which is Star Ocean, actually, right? And just form this new studio called 3Ace, right? But it's not exactly the true, actually, right? Because, well, let's be honest, Tales of got my own thing, and yeah, it's like you basically take the concept, right, of being a Star Ocean game, right, and just take this concept from the Tales of, right, like you have an arena, right, and you got the, action, action RPG styled gameplay, I suppose, right? Like you just supposed to approach the enemy, just will transport you to arena, right? No, just because you just fight on the arena, actually, in JRPGs, right? Like turn-based combat or action-based combat, that doesn't matter, actually, right? You're not supposed to actually take down the enemy on the global map, right? You're not supposed to fight enemy like in regular action RPGs, like Kingdoms of Amalur: Reckoning, for example, right? But like this game. And the series itself, actually, right, it's not like it's supposed to be, like, extremely special, because, again, right, why just take these elements, like, okay, yeah, it's supposed to be about cosmos, it needs to be some sort of Star Wars, right, but it's just continue to be JRPG, it's like Wild Arms, right, yeah, you got Wild West, you got Wild West aesthetics, right? But it's still a JRPG, typical JRPG, where you can have aliens, robots, and future stuff, and actually an actual fantasy stuff, right? Like magic, or I don't know, this Wild West vibe, like in Wild Arms, for example, right? But in this game, again, it's like it's not like it's supposed to be like a star. I don't know, it's supposed to be a game about space traveling, but it's have these elements, like, yeah, you got people who just travel through the space, like, and it's supposed to be like modern society, or modern people who just actually can just control the spaceships, right? And I occasionally land on some uncharted planet, right? And and have relationships with beings of this uncharted planet, actually, right? Yeah, but they have all these elements, right? But you're not even supposed to have JRPG series name like Star Ocean, actually, right? You can have just an ocean, I don't know, this name, right? And nobody will feel the difference because it's not a Star Wars. It's not have this standalone own thing like Jedi Knights, right? Or Siths, right? Or lightsabers, right? Yeah. But It's like, the way how we just try hard to create our own thing, actually make just this RPG and any other RPG look unique, actually, and feels unique. I don't know, just like, again, like Wild Arms, right? It's like, it's special in its own way if we're biting Kytus or, I don't know, just something like Planescape Torment. It's just... it's just one game is supposed to be like extremely philosophical, actually, right? And it just feels like a good book of like a Dostoevsky book, for example, right? And if you play something like Eternal Wings in the Lost Oceans, ocean, actually, right? You just have an epic story and an overall epic game, right? Playing something like Star Ocean is like having a unique game with some unique vibe, actually, right? But it's not supposed to be that special, right? But it's anyway deserved to be in RPG Legend list, actually, right? Legends list. And yeah, it's like you got like these all elements like in Western RPGs, like you supposed to have, you're supposed to learn skills, actually, right, of your character, right, in any way you want, for example, right, but it's anyway just ends up with you learning all of them, right? It's not like in Neverwinter Nights, you're not supposed to just learn every skill in the list, right? You only can just choose some of them, actually, right? I'll just, after you level up. And this game is compared to the second evolution, yes, except second evolution got like, just kind of deeper story, better character development, right? Because feel the story more deep, right? Because it's become more personal, right? With every character you control, it's become more personal. But, like, to be perfectly honest, first feeling, actually, when you start this game series, which is Star Ocean, actually, right? This game is far more warm, and have this homeland feeling, or home feeling, I don't know how to explain this, right? It's just like you feel yourself like you're just playing the right game at the right time, actually, right? So it's like second evolution for me, sadly, is just bleak copy of first depiction, right? Yeah, character development not that personal, right? It's more generic, actually, right? Because you got like the standard party of characters, right? The standard, I don't know, just way of you got the standard archetypes, actually, right, in this game. Again, the main character obviously is supposed to be some sort of warrior, right? She's supposed to be your girlfriend, right? I mean, just your childhood female girlfriend, right? But not an actual girlfriend, she's just a friend to you, right? Well, at least at the beginning, right? Because we don't know what happened in the end of the game, right? Obviously, but I'm not supposed to just say I'm not supposed to tell you any spoilers about this game, right? But I mean, like this, I don't know, just certain feeling what you just play the best Star Ocean game. It just follows me every way when I just play something like First Departure or any other Star Ocean game, actually, right? 3D games sadly not aged well, right, and not supposed to just be extraordinary, right? The last Star Ocean game, in way of graphics, was kind of good, right? But I'm not talking about like this new game, what's supposed to just come, right? Come out and been released, right? Like with Divide Forces, if I'm not mistaken, right? Because I just record this video on October 25, right? Year 2022, right? And new Star Ocean game supposed to be released like after 2 days, right? And I have no idea what quality it's supposed to be, right? But I mean, like the previous Star Ocean game, the last Star Ocean game, what just come out on PlayStation 4 was kind of good, but when you just it's like At the beginning, you think this game is kinda okay, but afterwards you understand what they just not put this amount of quality, actually, right? Like, cutscenes not supposed to be cinematic, actually, right? The dialogues is kinda bad, actually, right? And overall, this game is, you know, just feels generic, and generic something, actually, right? It's typical, straight, go and farm, and just sometimes have a story, just dialogues, right? Type of JRPG, right? It's like you just have a concept, right? But just a new engine, but people just too lazy to make to just put more amount of quality what you're supposed to to put actually in AAA JRPG game, right? This game being remastered like 2 times. My personal opinion, what the best remaster of this game actually is, obviously, as I always say, actually, right, what the best versions of JRPGs come out on PlayStation Portable. For what reason? I don't know, but the best version of this game, people will say it's Switch, I say no. No, it's PlayStation Portable. If you play on emulator or on actual PSP, you will feel the difference. Opening of this game is better on PlayStation Portable. Everything, I don't know, just from portraits of characters to the graphics, it's better on PlayStation Portable, right? Especially just if you play on emulator at 4K, right? I'm not playing on Nintendo Switch, actual Nintendo Switch, right? But I mean, yeah, it's like it's totally feels like Tales of Phantasia, but it's not supposed to be that epic. It's supposed to be more linear. But this opinion is obviously subjective, right? Like I can say what some RPG Legends games actually will be kind of subjective, actually, right? Well, I mean, you can say, like, well, just any human being anyways are supposed to be subjective, but I try to be objective, actually, right, here. But for me personally, I don't know, just I totally can explain it with Star Ocean in every way you just play it, actually, right? It's just feels far more better than Second Evolution. Right. If you got a good sense of taste, you totally just feel it almost every way you play, actually, right? Music, aesthetics, chemistry of this game, characters, it's classic. I don't know, fantasy with sci-fi fantasy RPG, action RPG, actually, right? It's not completely feels like Star Wars, right? But it's really Star Ocean. First Departure form this feeling of being a Star Ocean game itself. If only every game have this vibe, actually, right? You have this feeling in Second Evolution as well, but it's become much more slightly actually bleak, right, compared to the first Departure, right? Well, at least for me, first Departure is bright. First Departure is more emotional, right? Its story is kinda simple, actually, right? But I don't know, what you can call a good quality product, actually, right? Or, I don't know, I forget the word, I don't know. Just sometimes certain words what I need to just spell, actually, just fly away from my head. It's unbearable, actually, right? I don't know, it's what people called quality content. What's what I'm trying to say, right? This game, if you play PlayStation Portable version, it's pure quality content, actually, right? Right? And for me, Star Ocean, First Depecher, он же с оригинал, First Depecher, он же стал же... Yeah, it's like, at some point, Star Ocean, First Depecher, R got, он же, better, I don't know, just, I suppose, portraits of characters, right, and overall, just, I don't know, it's kinda, I don't know, just, only big difference between First Depecher R and First Depecher from PlayStation Portable, right, because original game was released on Super Nintendo, if I'm not mistaken, right, like, Tales of Phantasia, right, but since all these remasters got the openings, right, like anime openings, right, because anime opening in this game is just so, it just hit you much more deeper again, compared to the second evolution, right? Or Till the End of Time, for example, right? It's like, and this, it's like, you're not even supposed to just play it, actually, you just watch with, just 1 minute, just plus, I don't know, just, opening of this game, right? And you totally will feel the vibe of this game, right? This romantic, I don't know, just unique adventure in this new sci-fi fantasy world, actually, right? It's not supposed to be like Star Wars, like, it's not supposed to be sci-fi at all, actually, right? And to be perfectly honest, that's supposed to be a huge difference between actual sci-fi and universes like Star Wars, right? Because Star Wars is just basically, feels like fantasy, right? Universe, right? Not because we got like knights and lightsabers, right? But it's just have this old it's unique vibe of being Star Wars, right? Like this game, which is Star Ocean, actually, First Depecher got its own vibe of being like slightly Tales of game, right? And something new and unique, actually, right? And it's like, you will catch this vibe, with Tales of Vibe, only when you just see how a combat system, right, works in this game, right? But it's like, how the towns look, actually, how the world map look, how the game itself look, actually, with all these characters and story, it just form the unique atmosphere, aesthetics and everything, actually, right? I myself, adore this game, right? I think it's the best. Star Ocean game, which is Star Wars, which is Star Ocean, fucking idiot, Star Ocean game, right, my favorite, personal, and yeah, it will be extremely subjective, right, especially for the fans of the second evolution until the end of time, or even Last Hope, actually, right, but I think this is the best Star Ocean game, right, It will be my personal opinion. You can shoot, I don't know, just me from any weapons, I suppose, from any guns, right? But I mean, that's just how it is, right? I think this game got its own unique, extremely unique vibe, actually, of being Star Ocean game. If only every Star Ocean games, be like Star Ocean First Depecher, right? That's what we need to deliver, actually, right? When we create, It doesn't matter. It's like, it's supposed to be 2D game or 3D game. Doesn't matter. It's just all about this vibe, right? It's just a combination of character development. Creating a unique world, right? Music, opening, everything, right? It need to have this spark, right? Because this game totally have a spark actually inside of it. Being a Star Ocean game, right? So, yeah, totally deserve to be in RPG Legends list, right? And it was me, Igor Chernov, as always, actually, Star Ocean, the most adorable Star Ocean game, which is Star Ocean, First Depecher. I highly recommend to just play PlayStation Portable version, right? As always, right? Because, to be perfectly honest, Star Ocean, First Depecher Air got kinda shitty opening, right? Compared to the original opening, right? And you need to just get the copy of the game from PlayStation Portable. But this game can be played on any emulator, because we got extraordinary good PlayStation Portable emulator, right? And you can play in any resolution, right? Well, yeah, if you don't like в эмуляторах, если ползать, you can get a physical copy, obviously, right? On Switch, right? Or on actual PlayStation Portable, right? But, I mean, it's like, overall, just, I think the best version of this game is further the picture from PlayStation Portable, and this game totally, again, totally deserved to be in RPG Legends, right? Only game what you can compare to Star Ocean and the series, right? It's kind of, I think it's Wild Arms, actually, right? It's not supposed to be like, it's not supposed to be something like extraordinarily big and epic, like, Landscape Torment, right? Or Legend of Dragoon, but it's got its unique spark and vibe, and totally, it's like, if you are RPG fan, right, and you want to just try something new, right, this game is it's when you just play it, like, for the 20 minutes and be like, I'm home. This is the game for me, right? This game has something, right, what I like, actually, right? And it's basically, games like this can form the good sense of themes, the good sense of taste in gaming itself, and in RPG section overall, actually, right? Totally deserve to be in this list, which is RPG Legend with me, right? Star Ocean, first departure.